Welcome, builders of the internet. My name is Jessa and I work in construction. Today I thought I would talk about materials that are commonly used in the construction industry that can actually be pretty bad for the environment. Sometimes due to factors such as cost, availability, and just personal preferences when it comes to choosing materials, it can make it difficult to choose the more sustainable options. But I thought it would be worth discussing the environmental impacts of these materials and some potential alternatives. As always, you can find my sources in the description.
It's building on my mind.
Concrete. Concrete is the most used man-made material on Earth and has been in use for at least 9,000 years. It's unclear where it actually originated, but some of the oldest examples can be found in Galilee from 7000 BC and Serbia from 5600 BC. Some famous ancient structures made of concrete include the Roman Colosseum and the Pantheon. Nowadays, concrete is made of a mixture of cement, aggregates, which includes rocks and sand, and water in varying ratios according to what it's being used for. It's a relatively cheap material, strong, non-combustible, meaning it won't burn if it's exposed to fire, and it's easily shaped and lasts a long time, which is why it's so popular in use. It's often used for making curbs, pavements, pipes, bridges and buildings, roads and dams, and so much more in construction. The cement industry is one of the main producers of carbon dioxide in the world, so being an essential constituent of concrete, you can probably make a guess as to how bad for the environment concrete can be. Some of the substances present in concrete are toxic and radioactive, as well as having the potential to cause damage to soil in its waste products. Concrete can also produce dust when it's demolished, so when buildings are being knocked down or if they're damaged by natural disasters like earthquakes, it can actually be a major source of air pollution too. There is a lot of research going into producing concrete alternatives, which share similar properties but are less impactful to the environment. For example, there is grasscrete or hempcrete, which enables plants to grow on them and actually adds some water-absorbing properties too. There are also straw bales, bamboo, recycled plastic, and ashcrete, where byproducts of burning coal are used instead of cement. Each of these has various uses and varying degrees of effectiveness compared to concrete, so it is worth considering their individual pros and cons, though usually the determining factor for whether it's actually used is the cost. Because concrete is so cheap and readily available, it makes it pretty desirable, especially when compared to some of the more expensive sustainable options. Tarmac. Macadam was first developed in 1820 by John McAdam, where crushed small angular stones were very thoroughly compacted. This was more effective before motorized vehicles, where dust became a very prevalent issue, because cars actually crushed the stones from the road surface, which caused a lot of dust. In order to counteract this issue, a doctor in 1902 had the idea to mix tar with this mixture, so tarmacadam or tarmac was introduced. Tarmac nowadays is made of mineral aggregates such as cement, sand, gravel, or concrete, and the tar used to coat it is usually bitumen, which is a semi-solid form of petrol or a common byproduct of crude oil production. Tarmac is very water resistant, it has a relatively pleasant look while still having a superior grip, and it is relatively low cost and maintenance whilst still providing a high quality finish. This makes it useful for pavements, parks, playgrounds, car parks, and roads. Because of the way tarmac is made, with fossil fuels being heated to incredibly high temperatures, a lot of harmful emissions are produced and released into the atmosphere, including carbon dioxide. Similar to concrete issues, there is dust produced, as well as toxic byproducts, which are harmful to both human health and the environment. Using bitumen in tarmac doesn't appear to have health or environmental hazards at normal air temperature, but there is a lot of concern about the effect that hot bitumen has because the fumes are potentially carcinogenic. One of the main upcoming technologies in terms of tarmac alternatives includes permeable paving, which uses recycled plastic. This is arguably more durable than tarmac. It's frost neutral and can withstand high heat. There are some other options too, such as recycled rubber from old tyres, or finding a way to mix the materials together under lower temperature conditions, which can then reduce carbon dioxide emissions by up to 15%. Polyvinyl chloride. PVC or vinyl is a commonly used thermoplastic polymer, first made in 1872. It was patented for manufacturing in 1913, before being commercially produced in 1933. It's the second most manufactured plastic material after polyethylene and accounts for 20% of plastic manufactured worldwide. There are two main forms of PVC, one where it's pretty rigid or the second where it's a flexible plastic. This is typically made from salt and oil, which in this context is a non-renewable fossil fuel. It is cheap and more readily available when compared to some other materials. It has a lot of strength, it is quite dense whilst still being lightweight, and it resists deformation pretty well. It is also resistant to chemicals, and this unreactive nature makes it really useful for permanent structures in construction, where it's used for, say, window and door frames, pipes, other fittings, cables, types of wall cladding, roof, rainwater pipes, floor finishes, and wall finishes. Vinyl uses about 16 million tons of chlorine per year around the world, and PVC is found to have the largest production of organochlorine, which is a class of chemicals that are extremely hazardous. A large portion of these organochlorine mixtures haven't yet been identified or even tested. Byproducts of PVC tend to be toxic, they resist natural degradation, and can also be carcinogenic or just generally damaging to human health. Some of the alternative options include using recycled or reclaimed plastic, using bamboo and natural fibres for carpets and wall coverings, or utilising sustainably harvested wood. However, these are more expensive, more difficult to produce, and don't always perform as effectively at this current point in time compared to PVC. Nylon. Nylon was the first ever commercially successful thermoplastic polymer, first made in 1935 in a research facility. It was originally used in toothbrushes and stockings, then during World War II was found very useful for parachutes and their cords. They're made by reacting carbon-based chemicals found in coal and petroleum in an environment with lots of heat and pressure. Its properties include good weather resistance, a high melting point, it's very durable and resistant to mould, and can be drawn into flexible fibres, which makes it useful for tubes, pipes, screws, safety net, plumbing fittings, as well as carpeting in construction. Nylon tends to break down in fire and produce hazardous smoke and toxic fumes that contain hydrogen cyanide. When it's made, it produces nitrous oxides, which are supposedly more impactful than carbon dioxide, and lots of energy is used in the process. Discarded nylon takes around 3 to 4 decades to decompose, and is often found as debris in the ocean. At this moment, nylon recycling is an expensive and difficult process, so it's not a very desirable option, but many companies are trying to make this more efficient and effective. Alternative options are similar to that of PVC, including developing recycled plastic usability, bamboo, other hemp and wool products. As nylon is the most prevalent fibre for carpets, there are technologies being developed to reuse fibres from regenerated waste, as well as separating the dye used in its creation for use in future carpets. Insulation. The concept of insulation dates back to thousands of years ago, where the ancient Egyptians used mud to resist heat in their constructions. It then developed into asbestos, which was invented by the Greeks, though that is now known as something that is pretty toxic and hazardous to have in our homes. Romans were also found to have insulated their pipes with cork to transport hot water, so insulation has been around for a while. Nowadays, there are many different materials used to make insulation, and it's often a solution for making your house more energy efficient. However, there are more hazardous insulation products made of polystyrene and some types of expanding foam that are available. The property that all insulation materials should have in common is that they help minimize and limit heat flow. In buildings, this is particularly between the inside and the outside, so you usually find it in walls, floors and roofs to stop heat entering into the building in hot weather and to stop heat escaping from the building in cold weather. Styrofoam or expanded polystyrene is pretty harmful material to human health, wildlife and aquatic environments. In humans, it can cause respiratory issues, eye irritation, headaches, and dizziness. Some animals have been shown to have similar issues, as well as other symptoms like nasal irritation and effects on the stomach, the liver, and the blood. In polystyrene production process, there are also some suspected carcinogens produced. While the material itself is very rarely recyclable and is non-biodegradable, which carries detrimental effects on nature. Luckily, there are lots of relatively eco-friendly insulation options, such as cellulose, wood wool, cork, hemp, and sheep's wool. Some of these are relatively expensive and may not fare so well in damp environments compared to polystyrene and expanding foam, but generally they carry similar insulating properties, as well as having fireproof, breathable, and recyclable properties too. Thanks for watching this video. Whilst there are a lot of alternative options becoming available, you often find that unsustainable resources such as concrete and plastic are pretty cheap, readily available and easy to make, especially when compared to some sustainable alternatives. The demand for more renewable resources is likely to go up in the coming years to help meet sustainability targets set by the United Nations. So hopefully this can help the alternatives be mass-produced more efficiently, which could then help bring the costs down. If you would like to see more content to do with sustainability, construction, and mental health, feel free to check out my channel and please like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. That's all I have to say for now. I hope it helped build on your mind.
Thanks for watching this channel, it's building on my mind. Check out my other videos, but first hit the bell and comment, like, subscribe. Please, it really helps with you.